and no talking. I'm recording.
The Standardbred Pleasure Horse Association Organization, excuse me, of Ohio, presents the Standardbred. From the desire to win, American ingenuity created the world's fastest horse and harness, the Standardbred. The Standardbred before you is Sammy Merlot, three-year-old gelding by sire Victory Sam. Sammy is just beginning his harness racing career and is already winning. He's currently racing in Northfield Park near Cleveland with a racing stable, Last Laugh LLC in Bucyrus, Ohio.
I like that.
Holding the driving line is Kenny Edwards of Delaware, Ohio. Kenny's a well-known harness horse trainer and driver and an accomplished blacksmith. Kenny has won 127 races as a driver. As a trainer, he and his equine trainees have won more than $380,000 since 1991. The Standardbred originated as a family horse used for driving and performing farm chores. As roads of early America improved, the breed began to specialize in speed and stamina. Harness racing started as a sport contested on country roads for bragging rights. Anyone can own, train, and drive a Standardbred racehorse. Harness racing is popular throughout North America and the world. Harness racing is contested on either the trot or the pace. Sammy Merlot is a trot. Pacers move their legs on one side of their body in tandem, in a lateral motion. Hobbles, straps around the pacer's legs, help them maintain their gait while reaching high speeds. Pacers are more numerous than trotters and are usually faster. The trot is a two-beat diagonal gait where the right front and left rear move together. A Standardbred's gait is determined by genetics. Next in the arena is No Homework. Standardbreds like No Homework show us that the breed excels in harness off the track. Before becoming a pleasure and show horse in harness, Venus, as she is known, raced 85 times over 5 years. Her fastest winning time was 2 minutes 7 seconds. Today, No Homework is retired from a storied career as a show horse in harness and under saddle. She and co-owner Dale Pidcock competed in pleasure driving classes at Ohio Horse Show. They've won multiple year-end high point awards for driver. Dale and Venus also have won the Standardbred Pleasure Horse Organization of Ohio's High Point Driving title in past years. In addition to showing, No Homework has retired for several years as an unflappable member of the Central Ohio Mounted Search Unit. In 2008, Venus added side saddle riding to her repertoire, and she was ridden side saddle in the Pegasus Parade by co-owner Becky Pidcock during Kentucky Derby Week in Louisville, Kentucky, and in the Delaware, Ohio All Horse Parade with the Southern Ohio Ladies inside. No Homework now exhibits only as a Standardbred ambassador in events such as these. No Homework, like all Standardbreds, can trace her pedigree back to the founding sire, Hamiltonian 10, a great-grandson of the thoroughbred stallion Messenger. Messenger was imported from England in 1788. The breed developed great speed and stamina, a willing attitude, and a great work ethic with bloodlines from Narragansett Pacers, Norfolk Trotters, and Moorhounds. Next in the arena, Fire in Her Eyes. Mark Masters adopted Fire in Her Eyes from New Vocations Racehorse Adoption Program here in Ohio in 2000. Known as Midnight, this black daughter of Keystone Raider raced 10 times, earning $4,700. An injury ended her racing career. Since her adoption, Mark has enjoyed showing, barrel racing, and fox hunting. Midnight has a smooth rack prized by many gated horse riders. This gate has allowed her to compete successfully in pleasure shows and 100 paces, earning her over 100 awards. Her other true asset is her speed. She has become a top competitor in contestant competitions, earned 22 championship awards. To keep their training interesting, several years ago they took up fox hunting. They are now staff members with Miami Valley Hunt Club, based in Urbana, Ohio. The name Standardbred resulted because the earliest racehorses were required to trot a pace a mile in a certain standard time in order to be registered. The mile is still the standard distance covered in most harness races. Next in is Trabajador. Showcasing Huntsie today is SBHO youth rider Sarah Haynes and Trabajador. I'm sure I'm not saying it right, but Trabajador means worker in Spanish, and this 22-year-old mare is certainly that. Known as Trabi, she raced as a pacer from age 2 until age 5. George Conklin of Ashley, Ohio, owned, trained, and drove her in her 41 races. She won 4 races and earned $5,700. After she retired from racing, George's daughter, Selena, used her as a 4-H riding horse. After Selena outgrew 4-H, Trabi needed a new job. In 2007, Sarah, a beginner rider, started riding the mare. George saw something special between them, and he gave Trabi to Sarah. Trabajador is a wonderful teacher and partner for Sarah. In 2010, Sarah Trabi volunteered with the therapeutic riding program. Over the past 3 years, Sarah Trabi won multiple yearly championships through the StandardBred Pleasure Horse organization. Multiple ribbons at the Delaware County Fair and were named SBHO's Reserve High Point Youth. Names like Dan Patch, Greyhound, Niatros have made StandardBred racehorses mainstream heroes. The breed is everyman's racehorse. In addition, off the track, StandardBreds are the perfect family horse for pleasure or show. StandardBreds face every task put before them with gentleness, patience, and a heart that has no limits. Since 1938, the U.S. Trotting Association in Columbus, Ohio, has been the breed registry and official record keeper of harness racing. The USTA supports harness racing and the breed's versatility off the track. For more information, visit the USTA website, www.ustrotting.com. In 1982, StandardBred enthusiasts formed the StandardBred Pleasure Horse Organization. Today, there are separate SBHO clubs in Ohio, Florida, Maine, Massachusetts, New Hampshire, New Jersey, and California, and a similar club in Ontario. The groups encourage StandardBred versatility plus placement of horses after racing. Clubs sponsor clinics, classes, and open shows, StandardBred only horse shows, trail rides, and year-end awards. SBHO of Ohio is a very active club, and they welcome new members. Next in is Thank You Singer. Exhibiting dressage elegance are Heidi Leisure and Thank You Sam, 11-year-old gelding by the sire of Sun Sam. Sam has won $43,000 on the pace with a lifetime record of 1 minute. Sam retired from racing in 2007 and is now owned and ridden by Heidi Leisure. Heidi started showing Sam in 2008. They won multiple championships in the show. In 2009, Sam and Heidi earned the Reserve High Point StandardBred of the Year from the SBHO of Ohio. In 2010, they bested that with the High Point StandardBred of the Year. Also in 2010, Cassidy Leisure and Sam won the Lead Line Reserve Championship at the SBHO's Grand Circuit Classic. In addition to showing, Sam has given harness racing exhibitions at Equine Affaire and the Kentucky Horse Park. Next in is Inspector Hall. Inspector Hall and his owner, Mandi Cool, show us that saddleseat is another elegant sport at which StandardBreds excel. Known as Ace, this 5-year-old son of Like a Prayer did not race. Mandi adopted him for new occasions in 2009. Mandi trained Ace to saddle, and in the last year, they participated in 2 parades, their first overnight camping trip, rode in 100 pace, and exhibited the breed at the Kentucky Horse Park. Last summer, Mandi started his training from saddleseat. Ace has a good riding gait, and Mandi is working on turning him into a 5-gated show horse. 5-gated show horses perform at the walk, trot, canter, slow gait, and rack. Ace is easygoing, even weight, and very trusty in his rider, making him easy to train. Next in is Antique Collector. Antique Collector and his owner, Melanie Glover, demonstrate Western Parade. This gray son of law raced for 10 years, earning $259,000. He won 20 races and took a lifetime mark of 1 minute 51 seconds on the pace. During his race career, he survived a fractured ankle and a serious infection with West Nile virus. Melanie and her daughter, Lauren, adopted Antique from New Vocations in 2007. Besides being a good Western Parade winner, Antique Collector excels at showmanship. Melanie and Lauren enjoy taking Antique on the trails and showing in English and Western play. With his sweet nature and wonderful athleticism, he is a favorite of the barn. Owning a wonderful horse like Antique has fulfilled a lifelong dream for Melanie. Next in, Silver Match. Chris Glover, Melanie's husband, realized that if he wanted to spend time with Melanie and Lauren, he needed a horse too. So at age 50, when most men want to buy a Harley or a sports car, Chris started taking riding lessons in secret and looked to adopt a Standardbred from New Vocation. Doc Morgan, executive director of New Vocations, paired Chris with Silver Match. Match raced over 10 years and 287 races. He won 40 starts and $161,000. His fastest winning time was 1 minute 52 and 35 seconds. Today, Chris and Match ride in parades and explore the trails. Chris said, he loves to get out in front on the trail and move out. Instead of getting a sports car with hundreds of horsepower, I got one horse that is more fun, and my family and I have a whole new world to explore. Next is Win for Wendy. Standardbreds excel on the trail, and Win Her Wendy is a prime example of that. Wendy is a 20-year-old mare who never raced. In 1993, her owner and rider, Lois Bowery, trained her under saddle for trail riding. Since then, they have traveled more than 2,000 trail miles together. Lois says that it would be a little less if she could read maps. They have ridden in the Hoosier National Forest, the land between the Lakes National Recreation Area, and the Daniel Boone Trail. Their favorite Ohio trails are in the Hocking Hills. Wendy has drunk from an artesian well, stood at the foot of a waterfall, and slid on slate rock down the side of a mountain, and explored a cave. The pair also enjoyed showing and participating in parades, but Wendy's true profession and passion is exploring the trails. Next in, All-American Legacy. Entering the arena is All-American Legacy, known as Big Al, the Gentle Giant. He's shown today by Cindy Sheets and SBHO youth member, Cassidy Leisure. Cindy is a 4-H advisor for the American Dandies 4-H Club of Marlboro County, Ohio. Cassidy, age 5, has been showing lead line at SBHO of Ohio shows for the past 2 years and has won Reserve Lead Line Champion both years. Big Al is an unraised son of Dragon Again. Deborah Schiff, Cassidy's grandmother, adopted Big Al from New Vocation. Deborah is a Standardbred enthusiast and current president of the Standardbred Pleasure Horse Organization of Ohio. Big Al is enjoying his career in dressage and hunt season showmanship. In 2009 and 2010, he was the SDHO of Ohio's halter champion. Big Al exemplifies a typical Standardbred attitude. He's willing to try anything that is asked of him, and really loves the little ones. Next in, I Feel Lucky Today. Let us also welcome Lily Harriet as she proudly rides her grandmother's Standardbred, I Feel Lucky Today. Lily has been showing with Lucky in lead line and costume classes since 2009. And they won the lead line championship award from SBHO Ohio in 2009 and 2010. Lucky and her owner, Donna Harriet, have ridden thousands of trail miles across the U.S. and throughout Ohio. Donna, 17-year-old punter, won the SPHO of Ohio High Mileage Award for the most trails ridden in the past 3 years. And Lucky won the 100-point horse award from the SPHO of Ohio the past 2 years. Before Lucky became a trail mount, Donna trained and drove her during her racing career of 10 wins and $14,500. As you've seen today, most standardbreds are bay or brown. The black, chestnut, gray, and roan are also seen. White markings on the face and legs are common. Standardbreds vary in height, but most are 15 to 16 hands. In appearance, the standardbred combines the well-muscled physique of Morgans with the leanness of thoroughbreds. Stamina, an invisible quality, is another common attribute of the breed. Whether Western hunt seat, gating, dressage, or in harness, the standardbred could be the horse for you. They are the all-American racehorse, courageous jumpers, trail horses, barrel racers, endurance and police mounts. Standardbreds are intelligent, level-headed, and eager to please. The Standardbred Pleasure Horse Organization of Ohio invites you to our booth in the Cashman Breed Pavilion, booths B68 and 69, facing the Voinovich Demo Arena. Stop by and get more information about standardbreds off the track, as well as basic information on harness racing. Then stop at the booth next door to learn about horse adoption through new vocations at booth B7. Meet our standardbred ambassadors and you will fall in love with the all-American breed. Standardbreds. Nothing standard about them.
Work it, Dale.
Exactly.
Get that old girl going.
She could still move.
At least she's trotting today because yesterday she was pacing.
That's what Becky said.
She gets nervous and she paces a little bit.
Next up in the Coliseum today will be the Gypsy Banner Horse and the Gypsy Horse.